Nickel plate road was defined by its high-speed service of the 1950s, and the red and off-white cabooses bringing up the rear of those trains were a staple of the railroad's identity. Perhaps the most famous of the bunch were the 400 series bay window cabooses. These steel cabooses were home designed and built in Conneaut, Ohio, starting in 1952 across four orders. The majority of the 400 survived into preservation, leaving no shortage of reference photos. With this in mind, I wanted to rebuild my first 8-wide model from 2 years ago for the 2021 Brick Train Awards. Using real diagrams from the Nickel Plate Road Historical and Technical Society, I designed and rebuilt the caboose from the ground up. I chose to model 423, as preserved at the Mad River and Nickel Plate Road Railroad Museum in Bellevue. Why 423? Well, it was very likely that this was the first one that I saw as a kid before seeing any of the other preserved examples, and I wanted to reflect that in my own LEGO series. Plus, 423 is the only preserved bay window I have seen that would have operated behind steam, albeit briefly, being built in 1956. Now the caboose is not just another LEGO train. It has been accurately scaled down and designed to pack as much detail into the model as possible. I used Brick Model Railroaders KD couplers and plane bearing truck design for the bogies and packed as much underframe detail as I could in between. While this detail can be seen well enough from the sides, it can best be viewed when the caboose is on its side. Now the ends feature a healthy amount of detail with the handrails modeled where appropriate. The roof proved to be the biggest challenge, with angled hinge plates giving it a nice 10-degree angle with holes for the stovepipe and radio antenna. This was achieved as a removable section to show off the interior. The interior has an accurate layout with one creative liberty. On one side, you'll notice that the crew's bunk bed is a bunk, and the other side has been cut down to a single bed, to reflect how many of these cabooses look today after the Norfolk and Western removed the top bunk. Overall, I am extremely pleased with the end result of this model. I say model because LEGO is merely a medium that it's created in, and it's no different than any kitbash model to ensure its accuracy. While this may not be one of the biggest or grandest entries in the Brick Train Awards, this caboose is a labor of research and love and executed to as high of a standard that L-Gage can allow.